going to introduce Zeus to the paper plate recall. Here. So the paper plate recall is a really old exercise. It's an exercise that Margot Woods came up with. And basically you can use a plastic plate, you know, a frisbee is what I'm using right now. So I'm using just a frisbee. I use frisbees because it has a little bit of a lip and also because it won't blow away in the wind. So sometimes I have been out there with a paper or a plastic plate and it's gone for a ride in the wind, okay? So this way it's not going to get knocked over and the food's not going to come out. So basically, I'm going to put maybe about 2 kibble. So I'm going to use the dog's food, put about 2 kibble on here in order to engage the dog to do what I want it to do, okay, as motivation. So the dog is going to be doing a few different things during this exercise. It's going to be sent away from me. It's going to come back to me. It's also going to be learning impulse control to resist the impulse and the urge to get up and go after the food before it's supposed to, okay? So we're going to give this a go with food here. And Zeus is like a 5.5-month-old Doberman. I am using my marker, right? So I'm marking the desired behavior they want. I want him to sit. I don't teach stay, so it's implied that the dog stays there. Okay. He's also distracted by a dog over here. Sit. Good. They want the dog to stay there. I'm going to walk away a little bit, maybe about 7 or 8 feet here. Good. I'm going to remind him to stay put. I'm going to put 2 pieces of kibble here. I'm going to pick up the one that I dropped. I'm going to walk back. It's important that you go back to the dog, okay? You're going to go back to the heel position. You're going to use a hand signal. Hey, sit. Good. To send the dog off. Go get it. Now I'm going to call it back. Just come. Sit. Good. I'm going to reward him. And I'm going to get into the heel position again. Sit. So I am using the e-collar for this exercise. You can do it without the e-collar. All you're going to be doing is calling him to come to you and tell him to heal, but it's verbal, okay? But right now I'm training this guy for e-collar. Sit. Good. I'm also talking a lot, so that's going to be a distraction for him too. So I'm going to put the food down. Walk back. Go get it. Send him off. Just come. I would say maybe 15 feet away. I'm going to walk back. He's looking at me for the signal. Go get it. For him popping up. Put the food down. I'm going to walk back to him in control position. Go get it. Go. Good boy. Yep. Good. I'm going to walk up. 30 feet or so. This is how far I would go with this dog, because he's only 5.5 months old, okay? I'm not going to push him too much. Thank you. some dogs that are not used to doing some basic obedience, it's going to be hard for you to turn your back on the dog. So if you're walking up to the plate and your dog is a beginner, and you're not doing too much work, walk away from the dog this way. Otherwise, every time you turn your back, the dog's going to move, okay? So you've got to do lots of repetition. I'm training this dog myself, so I'm more comfortable with turning my back, okay? But for dogs that are beginning,